What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video, and I'm coming at you guys again today with another live commentary. This time, going over Dima's Memories, that sort of VR puzzle that you enter during the quest Best Left Forgotten. So for those of you who don't know, this is a main quest in the game, and it's a very tedious sort of VR puzzle that you have to go through. I sort of did it all on stream, but I thought I'd make a separate video sort of tutorial based on this, and a live commentary for you guys today. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and enter the terminal, and we'll go ahead and enter the first puzzle here. I'll go over some of the basics while inside of there, just to give you guys a bit of a rundown. And by the way, there will be timestamps in the description down below to each individual memory. There's 5 in total. Of course, they progressively get harder. So if you're stuck on one, you can simply get the timestamp down below, and of course, that should take you to the desired memory. So we've just loaded in to the first memory here, and just to give you guys a bit of a rundown of what's going on, the idea of this is to get the sprites, also known as the indexes, I believe, basically these small little things here, and guide them all the way over to the huge orangey-yellow beam in the sky, and guide them all the way back to the beginning, essentially where they place the data. So they go over there, they bring the data all the way back around, and they bring it back here. And each of those sprites represents 20% of data, so when one goes over, gets the data, comes back, that's 20% complete. And of course, if you get all 5 over there, that's 100% complete. And sometimes, basically, these turrets will kill them, so they'll respawn and have to go again. But that's just a general idea of the goal you need to actually fulfill. Now, to fulfill that goal, this is where the puzzle comes into play. And a bit of a rundown of the puzzle, there's basically 3 things that you need to know. One is these code blocks here. Basically, you can go ahead and store those. They're essentially just these normal blocks, but they're much brighter and stand out. I mean, you can kind of clearly tell which one's which. And of course, they do actually highlight as well. And the idea behind these code blocks is basically they're your path. You use these, as you can see now, to create a path for not only you, but as well your indexes. So I actually just completely misplaced that one. And when you do that, they can now move across. And that's the general idea behind the code blocks. And again, you'll see here now, you want to make a good use of them. So again, look around on each level, and then make sure you pick up as many as you can and store them. And of course, you know, make sure you're using them correctly, and you know, you actually create a viable path for them to go on. They only need sort of 1 block to go on, but I like to you know, create 2 sometimes, as they go seem to go a little bit quicker with that anyway. Now, the next block you're looking for is this one here, which I'm going to go to now, which is the decoder beam. And the decoder beam is actually over there for the first level, which kind of makes it a little bit awkward for me to explain. But essentially, what the decoder beam does, you can see here, here is the starting point of the green beam. And basically, what you want to do is you want to get the starting point of the green beam, and you basically want to unlock the firewalls by hitting these things right here. Basically, this is like, you know, the thing you need to hit in order for it to open. So you can see here now, when you remove this, the beam is now hitting that, which now opens up the firewall and removes the big red blocks out of the way. And again, all you need to do is simply move your indexes over. So again, place down your code blocks. I need to go ahead and collect some here, and you can go ahead and send those across. I'm just quickly going over the basics for you guys. I know a lot of you guys may already know this stuff, but I want to make sure you guys know what's going on as I do progress here. So again, boom, we've got a pathway. Now, this is the decoder beam. This is basically what sends the, you know, the original beam from its starting point in a completely different direction, and it will basically move left or right at a 360 degree angle. You can't change it to go up or down or anything like that. But you can see here now, using this, we can simply switch this around. The beam will always go towards where the green side of it is. So as you can see, you know, the green side of the decoder relay is on the right side. So again, when we place this block down, the green beam is now going to move to the right, and again into the firewall opening, therefore opening up a pathway for me and the indexes to now cross again. And that's basically the general idea of it. Now, the third thing you need, which we'll go ahead and place here now. Once again, I need to go ahead and collect all of these code blocks here, which we'll do right now, get as many as we can. But the third thing is the turrets, and you need these because as soon as you get over there to the final part, you're gonna have these things come after you. So you're gonna wanna make sure you put down some turrets. I'm gonna try and place one down here, kind of facing that way. I like to put 2 down at where like the ending is, pretty much where you get the little indexes, collect the data from. As you can see now, those turrets are attacking. And you'll see now the indexes or the sprites, whatever you wanna call them, they'll go in, they'll collect data. When they collect data, they should have a little marker on their head, which you'll see here in a sec. And you also want to set up some turrets around so they don't die. So again, we're going to put 1 in the middle. Then what we're going to do is we're going to put 2 down here, I believe. Well, we'll put 1 down here, and then we'll put another 1 down here. And it's just about kind of spreading your turrets out evenly. Oh, I'll put that down a little bit weirdly there. Again, oh, there we go. That's good enough. Oh no, he's actually shooting at it. As you can see, we're sort of doing this bad right now. And he's actually took out one of our little indexes there. So that's what you want to watch out for. Make sure you don't do that. Make sure you put your turrets down properly. And hopefully they should now take him out. Hopefully that's in a good enough position now. That shouldn't be able to cross this time. And the indexes should be good. So that one's going to be 80%. And then the final one is now going to be 100%. My turret placement was definitely not too great there. But basically, you just want to sort of even them out. You know, think about where they're going to go. And sort of even them out in general. Now, once you've actually got them all over. And you've done 100%. All you now need to do is move on to the next memory. By entering the orange portal there. So now that we've got the basics down, we can just jump straight into this. Now, this is the second level. And basically, to start things off, the main thing you might really want to look out for is where the starting beam is going to be, or where, you know, the location of where the starting beam is going to be. And as you can see, looking to my right, there's the star, and it seems to go underneath, shoots a beam against this block. So we're going to go ahead and remove that. And that will now send power all the way through there. I'm presuming those green blocks are pretty much power blocks, and therefore sending the beam now through there. So now I have to go ahead and jump back up. I've also collected a block as well. You know, check around again to see if there's any more blocks you can pick up. And now, as you can see, the beam is going through there. So we just need to remove this block here. Let it go ahead and go through. And we'll go ahead and collect some of these code blocks as well. Once we've done that, we'll then go back and check where that beam is now going. So now the beam's actually hitting against the wall. And what we now need to do is remove this block again. Pick up the decoder relay and pretty much turn this around. Place it on there again. So the green arrow is pointing that way, sending the beam through there. If we go ahead and pick up some more blocks again, we can go through here this time. We can see where the beam's going. It's sort of hitting against something invisible right now. Oh no, it's perfect. And now what we need to do is, again, just build up. So we build from here, I guess. We can sort of see where the beam needs to hit there. So what we need to do is place it in the middle. Let's go ahead and put this back up. Place two down and then one more decoder beam, which we can't actually get right now because it is here. And then place it down with the green beam facing this way. Bam, there we go. So the second one is actually pretty easy. In fact, pretty much all of them up until the last one is pretty easy in my opinion. And some may even say the last one's easy, but again, this is for those of you who do struggle with it. And again, just picking up all these blocks here and then making a pathway for those little indexes. Now what I'm gonna do beforehand actually, oh, I just completely died. You don't die. Another thing is you don't actually die when you fall down. You pretty much, I'm gonna go ahead and set up my turrets here. You just fall down and then it sort of respawns you. I'm going to put another turret down here, I think, maybe. Put one down here. And then we'll carry on going. We'll put one down over here as well. Round about here. We'll have it facing those freaking robots there already. Get it out there. Put another one. Three more. We are now good to go. So let me go ahead and place down the last turret right here. Hopefully these turret placements are good. Probably not. Definitely not the best at this, but bam, there we go. Hopefully that should get things rolling. And these indexes should now do the job. I mean, at this point, as long as you have turrets down spread out, you could just literally go AFK for a bit. They will eventually do the job. But again, you can move these turrets around if you like. I mean, you can just pick them back up and simply move them around. As you can see now, they do have a marker on their head as well, just to let you know they do have data on them. Seems to be working perfectly fine right now. We don't have any of those freaking robot things. I forgot what they're called. Defense con. No, that's what I have. I'm not too sure what they're called again, but yeah, they are going all in and 100% flawless run for the second memory there. And now we move on to the third memory. Again, you know, it's just sort of giving you guys the basics here leading up to the last one, and hopefully now you guys are getting a bit of a general idea of what's going on. So here's the third one. Again, they do get progressively harder, and to begin with, just straight away remove these blocks off the first part. Get removing them here, and you'll see now that opens up, you know, whatever, you know, the opening part of the firewall there, and straight away that becomes, you know, gone because the beam is straight in the middle. Now what you want to do, of course, is make these cross again. So just simply place down your blocks. We're going to go 2x2 again, try and save as many blocks as we can. And now what we need to do is we need to send the beam into there. So we just simply need to go ahead, place a block down. Now what we need to do is actually find the next block, which I believe should be up here somewhere. Go ahead and jump. Go ahead and make a big jump into there. And as you can see, there is the decoder relay. So pick them all up. Once you've picked them up, simply go back down. Place the relay down again. This time we need to make sure it's on the left. There we go. And that should now open up the second firewall. I do apologize if I'm getting things mixed up, my wording, you know what I mean? Like, I'm actually naming things wrong. But, yeah, we can go ahead and pick up the third relay then. Connect all of these wonderful blocks. And that should now also power that there. Oh, we actually need to make it power that, actually, sorry. So we need to move those blocks a little bit over to the left, I believe. So we go ahead and now pick up these blocks one by one. We pick them up, place them there, there, and then place it right there. And then what we'll do is remove these blocks. That'll now power a beam going up to there. Again, removing this firewall, which is pretty cool. And now, again, we just seem to need to go ahead and place down blocks. We're going to go 2x2 again. Made a pathway for those guys. And I think we nearly are done. What we need to do now is go up to the top. So we got to go all the way up to the top again. And climb up this way. Come on, get up. Boom. And we need to send that beam from there over to here. Hopefully this is helping you guys out, by the way. I do apologize if it's going quite slow. I wanted to do this live instead. Makes things a lot easier when actually recording. And I feel like you guys would enjoy it more if it's live as well. You get a bit of a better understanding rather than me trying to explain things over excessively. So, boom, we've got the firewall open now. And we are ready to get these freaking indexes, or sprites, I guess you can call them, over there again. So we have 13 blocks. What we're going to do is we're going to go bam. This point, we're near enough good. We'll place, I guess, another one down here just in case any does manage to cross in here. So we'll place one down, maybe there for now. That'll be one we can pick up and move around if we ever need to. So we've got two fighting there. Now what we need to do is place down some more blocks. Let these guys cross. And they are good to go now. There we go. Come on, sprites, you can move. Two of them actually died, which means that those freaking things over there actually killed them. Oh, no, they didn't. Oh, I thought they did. We are good then. And for the third one, again, we get another flawless run. It's actually quite funny how I actually kind of didn't get a flawless one on the first one, but the second two, I actually do. But again, we're now onto the fourth one and then onto the last one afterwards, which I'm pretty sure is the one that most of you guys are going to be kind of stuck on or want to know how to do efficiently. So onto the fourth one now. Basically, what I suggest as well is that you listen to Dima as he's, you know, as you're unlocking the memories. I'm not going to have that in the gameplay in the background because I don't really want to spoil too much of it, but it's pretty awesome what you find out in this location, believe me. So it's definitely one that you're gonna want to listen out for. So as you can see, the fourth one definitely looking a little bit more complicated, but it shouldn't be too much of a struggle here. We'll go ahead and pick up these code blocks straight away. If I do remember how this one works, I only did it once and that was on stream, so I haven't really gone back to check, but I do get a general idea of what's going on now. We go ahead and place down a block right there, right there, right there, and we'll place the decoder relay also, but just beam mover, I guess, for short, and I place it there. Boom. Oh, we need to place it one higher. I am stupid, making mistakes already. And I pick it up, place it there, and it now opens that up. Pick up another decoder here, and now what we do from there is pretty much remove the blocks, which I just did there. I had to cut that part out real quick because I did actually make a mistake. And what you now need to do is simply place another block there, right there, and there again. And we need to send the beam going this way this time. So we're going to go ahead and place it right there. Now I'll send the beam over that way. Then we need to get these blocks out again. But a little bit of a wall here. We'll see what that beam's going. So it's going right there. Need to put it there. One, two, three. And then the decoder goes this way, right into that firewall there. And we are good to go from there. That now opens up the big area. And now what we need to do is that, again, we need to go ahead and collect some more blocks. But we also need to take all of these away now. So we'll go ahead and take all these away. As you can see, it's definitely looking a lot more complicated now. But what you want to do now is you want to take all these blocks away, including this one as well. And you want to send that beam going down through the floor. And you'll see here why now that we actually need to do that. So go ahead. And now what we want to do is we want to go down. I believe there's a pathway just here. You can see. Right next to the power, I guess you could call it. Those power blocks there. And you want to get the beam going down this way. Because now what you're going to do, you're going to place one, two, and then you're going to put the beam on top facing this way. And that's going to send the beam all the way down here, as you can see. And now what we need to do is place a block down here. And then another one facing this way. Boom. That powers up that, removes that firewall over there. And we are now good to go. We can go ahead and remove it. I don't think we really need it at this point. and we should be able to just build a bridge straight over now. And that should be the fourth one pretty much done. Yep, as you can see, indexes are already halfway there. So we need to place two blocks there, another one there. Let me place one there. In fact, what I'm going to do before I actually pick up the rest of the blocks is I'm going to go ahead, place on my turrets one there. I'll place another one down right here. And then pretty much just spread them out all along this way. So we'll go bam. We'll go like this. And then we'll put one more down over here somewhere. We'll put it probably down right here. Okay, maybe there. Or maybe one down. Going straight. Go ahead and make a path for these guys real quick. That's probably about as best as I'm going to do just for now. Probably missing a few blocks somewhere again. You know, this is just a pretty general guide. I'm not really going too in-depth as the best ways to do it, because either way, you're going to get it done. But here we go. We've got the indexes going over. Hopefully, again, those turrets are placed well. Seem pretty decent placement here. We've got a bit of a crisscross going on. Plus the two at the main part there. I always like to put two down at the main because I feel like that's where most of the attacking is going to go down. But and we can finally move on to the last one. The one that probably most of you were wanting to see the tutorial for. But again, I just wanted to do the whole thing anyway, just to get it primarily out of the way there. So we got him back there. I should have been over here already waiting. Wasting a lot of time not going there. And on to the final memory. Now this one, at first you may think, oh, I mean, it's right in front of you. I mean, there's the freaking orange portal. I mean, you just need to unlock this, right? But then you turn around and, oh my god. Yeah, there is a huge, huge puzzle that you'll need to go with. So first things first is you want to pick up all these blocks here. Hopefully I can ace this in one go and not have to think about anything, because once again, I only did this once. We're going to pick up all these blocks here, including that one at the end there. So we're going to go ahead and collect that one. The ones that I only suggest you leave here are, I mean, you can even take the one, which I'm going to show you guys here in a sec. We're going to leave that one there because we're going to need that. And usually I would tell you guys to leave that one as well. But what we'll do first actually is we'll go ahead and collect that freaking decoder relay over there. And what I like to do is just do that and then jump, you know what I mean? Like create a little bit of a space to sort of maximize the amount of blocks that you're going to get there. So once you pick that up, head back. You don't need to mess with this part of the area right here just yet. We'll be going back there soon. But what you do want to do is you want to place one more block down here and then make a running jump. Hopefully you'll make it. So as you can see, here is where the beam starts. And then you need to get the beam to go into that freaking opening there, which is extremely difficult because you'll notice here that you can lift these blocks off. You can take them away. But it's this block here that you'll need to send the beam through. And because this is, you know, a static block that won't move, you can't send the beam directly from here. You need to get it there in a very specific way. So if you go ahead and once again, keep removing all these blocks here. Make sure to get all the openings ready as well, because you're going to need to send the beam through a couple of these. And the final two here, we should be good to go. So the first thing you'll need to do is move the beam from the middle to this side of the, you know, the area. You're gonna want to get it straight into that freaking opening there to unlock this firewall here. And to do that, you need to get the beam going through here. And of course, to do that, what you need to do is you need to first of all simply store the decoder, place two blocks high, and then place the decoder going this way. So we need to switch it around, place it on top, and boom, the beam is now going to go straight through and unlock that firewall. So what we can now do is move across, place it a little bit weirdly there. Just keep moving, place one more block down and make a running jump. Hopefully I don't miss this. A lot of the time on stream I kept missing that. So we have another decoder block we can pick up. And to the left here, you're going to want to do this now. It's just keep going across because there's a bunch of blocks you can pick up. And this will sort of save you a lot of time because there's a lot of blocks you need to place down. And it's good to just collect all of these. So we're just finishing that up now. Boom, we got a mall and we're going to head back. And as we do head back, we're also going to go ahead and collect the blocks that we did use. I know it's a long process, but it's definitely worth it in the end up. You won't need to worry about like, oh, I just need to freaking rob the block I was on there. And it's just good to get them in general. I mean, it's not really too needed. I think I did most of it without that, but it's just there to help you guys out as well. And also you can actually jump and collect some up here as well. So again, collect as many of these as you can. Just keep collecting, collecting, collecting until you are all done at this point. I think you collect the two here. And I'm only going to try this once because I don't like this jump. I missed it once, but try one more. And I got it. There we go. Nice. That one's a little bit too high there. But once you've got it going over there, what you now need to do is get it up there, which is four blocks high from where I am, I believe. Is it four blocks? Yes, it's four blocks. So we need to go back to the center, place down three blocks. One, and then three. Then we need to go ahead and send the decoder this way. And boom, that's gonna unlock that. Once it's unlocked, again, build a bridge over, make a running jump, pick it up. Now the beam's coming over here. And we need to send the beam through there. So the first thing we need to do is just simply build. In fact, we'll actually build it up there now. So we need to go 4 high again, just to save a lot of time here. We're going to build 1, 2, 3, and then we'll build 1 right here. Bam, there we go. Sending it straight through there. And boom, we can go ahead and send that beam through there. Keep going with it. It may not seem too much of like, as I'm doing this now, knowing how to do it all, it may not seem too difficult for you guys watching, but trust me, at the time, and I just fell off the edge, god damn it. But yeah, at the time, it was quite difficult just trying to figure it all out and stuff. But now that I've got the hang of it, it's actually quite a lot easier. So again, picking up all the blocks here. We've got the beam going all the way through. That's powering that now, which is good. And now what we need to do is head all the way back. We can actually build a bridge over to save time. Just waste a few blocks, but we should be good. I'm going to try and save as much time as we can here. Going across. And now we've got all the beams going around. So we have all the beams going around and heading straight over through that power outlet there and going up into there. We now can move on to this area of the map. We can jump there and we can simply head up these stairs here. So heading up, you don't need to worry too much about the bottom area here. Just go straight up and then turn. Oh, I just completely missed the jump and turn again. And we are now good to go. So keep going up again. Remove these blocks here and we should be able to get a look at the beam now. There we go. We can see the beam coming through. Again, just going to remove all these blocks, get them out of the way, and we should. Pretty good. That's pretty good. You guys know where that's from. But what we need to do now is we need to send it down to the bottom one there to unlock that firewall. So to do that, I think we just need to go straight down from there, that little hole there. So all we need to do for that is to simply put a block down there in the corner. Again, I'm actually quite stupid. All right, we're gonna put it down there and then over the actual middle. I have no idea why I didn't do that. What is going on right now? Oh, there we go. All right, now we're good. We're getting there. That should send it over there. That unlocks the firewall. And of course, we now have the last two decoder blocks that we're gonna need. So we're gonna build a bit of a stairway up here real quick because we do need to actually collect that coder block there. We don't need it to go up there, we just need to simply collect it. Boom, we got it, and then collect the other one here. And then go back and actually get the other one. So now at this point, you are pretty much done. I'll show you guys the final setup there. The main thing with this is you're going all the way around with the beam to unlock those firewalls to then have, exactly as you'll see here now, you want exactly 3 of these spare with the beam going through the power. So you'll see here now, watch, I'll show you guys. So we need to go back to spawn. We have 3 of these, which is just perfect. We're going to go ahead and jump off here and then head all the way back to spawn here. So again, you need to have the beam going through there, going up to there, and you need to have 3 decoder blocks spare. That's the whole purpose of it. So what you want to do from here is simply put a decoder block right there. It needs to be facing this way as well. And the reason why, of course, no, it needs to go one higher, sorry. There we go. It needs to go there. And basically what that's going to do is it's going to send the beam through there and then over to that firewall. So now what we need to do is simply build out to here, and we now need to build outwards. We've got 2 more decoder blocks, so we can send the beam in this direction and then in that direction, if that kind of makes any sense. So we're gonna build up here. Real quick, we're gonna put a block down so I can actually go ahead and place stuff down here. We need to put 1 more block down actually, and then place it right there. That's gonna send the beam. Oh, we're going in the wrong direction. We're gonna go ahead and flip that around again. Place it there. That's going to send the beam in that direction. Now what we need to do, you guys probably get the general idea now, is build up again. We only have 5 blocks here. And then up. And then for the final part, hopefully I'm doing this right. Get the beam going there. Can we actually get it to place? And that should, oh, we need to go 1 higher. My bad. So we've actually had to place these 1 higher. I did actually make a mistake in going 1 too low there like an idiot. I like you guys are probably like, you know, what have you done wrong in the comment section? But I did fix it. I did make a mistake. That is quite ironic considering I'm making a tutorial on this and I'm not supposed to be making mistakes. But yeah, we are good. As you can see, power's going through there, to there, and then eventually to there. And eventually knocking down that firewall there. So We're gonna go ahead and jump down. That'll respawn us. And that just gives you guys a general idea. Again, I ain't, you know, the cleverest person in doing this. I ain't by any means freaking, you know, probably the best person or doing it in the best way. But it gets the job done and gives you guys a general idea of how it works and how to actually get this whole thing done. And all we need to do really here is just place down a bunch of turrets here. I mean, it's right there. And we are done, guys. That is pretty much how it works. I mean, I don't really need to show you guys the rest of this because it pretty much is going to get done itself. But I will go ahead and show you guys the rest of the gameplay of these little things moving across. This one here is a little bit confused right now. He doesn't know what's going on. See if we can give him a little bit of a budge. You can sort of budge them a little bit, which is pretty cool. But yeah, my friends, that is how it works. It makes them a little bit tedious at the start. Even I was making mistakes while making this tutorial. So you guys, you know, will probably make mistakes even watching this. But trust me, at the beginning, for me, this was quite difficult, which is why I wanted to make this tutorial for you guys today. So again, hopefully this has helped. Of course, if it did help you guys out, be sure to let me know by leaving a like down below. We have now completed the memory, so all we have to do is just stand inside, and we are pretty much good to go. So hope you enjoyed, subscribe if you're new, and I'll catch you guys next time with a brand new video. Peace out.